David Coverstone has had several dreams now. He's had many, many, many dreams. A lot of people out there just laugh at him, don't take him seriously. Well, in this house, I'm gonna take him seriously. My husband, my family, we're taking him seriously. You do know the American government is preparing what they need to do during another lockdown. The flu season's coming upon us, along with the other corona and all of that. Everybody's gonna get sick. The kids are going back into school. Families are starting to not meet outside, and they're getting bored. They're getting bored of having to social distance, and kids are having parties. Stay home, teenagers. You're making your parents and your grandparents sick. That is a fact. So let me show you what we're doing that maybe you could do to prepare just in case something were to happen, because you don't want to not be prepared. That's silly. We've got 20% of America saying, hey, nothing's gonna happen, nothing's gonna happen, move on. And the other 80% of us are saying, maybe you should prepare, maybe you should listen to the rest of us. Just maybe. Let me show you what we're doing here, just to give you maybe some ideas, because maybe there's some things you haven't thought of. First off, let me show you this. That is powdered eggs. Powdered eggs. My mom and dad bought me that from Amazon. The shelf life on this is 10 years, unless you open it. But when you open it, you have to use water with it. So I have taken the liberty to can some water. This is sterile water. Also, in case you have like cuts or fractures or something, well, maybe not fractures, cuts, you need sterile water. I did this in my canner. Water bottles, gallon water jugs, fill those up, because you know what, you're going to need them to use the eggs. All right, moving on. I've also canned flour, because bag flour gets bugs in it. I also have bag flour. I'll use that first. I've been canning flour to save long term. This is gonna last a long time on a shelf. I've been dehydrating. This is corn. I've dehydrated corn because if for any reason you have to up and move your family, it's easier to move this than it is a whole bunch of corn. And if you have freezer corn and things like that, what's to say the power isn't gonna go out? So think ahead. I also have dehydrated green peppers. You can dehydrate anything. You can dehydrate anything you want. Spices, this is onions, the long onions. I've ground this up. I dehydrated it, ground it up, made my own powder. You can make your own powder. This is celery. I put it in my dehydrator, ground it up. I made my own celery seed. Let's think about this logically. Do you need toilet paper or do you need rice? Let's think about that. Because I'm gonna put this down because it's pretty heavy. The last pandemic that we went through, everybody hoarded toilet paper. You don't need to do that. It may sound gross, but you can make your own toilet paper. You can do that. You can use an old shirt and just wash it. You know, you can do things like that. So you don't need to hoard the toilet paper. Buy rice, flour, things like that. Beans. I've got beans. Beans. And with that, you need water. You can't do all this stuff without water. So make sure you're storing up water. Plus you need to drink the water. Also canned meat. You may say, I hate canned meat. You're not gonna hate it during a pandemic when there's nothing else to eat. Canned chicken, I have canned chicken. You can get tuna fish. You can get Spam. I love Spam, so I'm in luck there. But Spam, also, if you have ground beef and it's still okay, now, you know, you can can ground beef, and I'm gonna look into doing that and make a video on how to do that. So subscribe if you're not subscribed, because I'm gonna learn how to can ground beef and I will show you how to do it. Manwich, but look at this. You see that? If there's no power, how are you gonna open that? It's all about thinking ahead and being prepared. Get yourself a can opener, a hand crank can opener. Something else, pasta. This is dried, anything dried can sit around for a while. I'm sorry, I keep looking away because I've got my little pile. Yeast, you make bread with yeast. For those of you that don't know, you need yeast. Yeast was hard to find, flour, and a few other things. Those were hard to find. Go buy yourself some yeast. I went to Sam's Club and bought a big one, a big canister of yeast, so we have that here. Now, with all this being said, let's think about this. Let's think the projected, the worst, okay? Think the worst. Play that scenario in your brain. If you have no electricity, you need to cook outside. What are you going to cook on? You're going to have to collect firewood. Let me show you this. That's a cast iron pan. I've got potatoes on top of it now. And it's too heavy for me to pick up. But it has the lid that comes off. This is a very heavy pan. That's a cast iron skillet. If you're planning on cooking over a fire, you need some cast iron cookware. You need that because you can cook over heat with that. Try to put one of your regular baking pans on a fire, you're going to melt it. So there's a lot of things that you could plan up for. If you have gas cans, keep them full. Simple things, but think ahead. Plan ahead. What do you think you might need if something terrible were going to happen? If all the power was shut off, do you have a well? Is that how your waters run? Right now, canning jars are really hard to find. Also, are the pressure cookers. They're hard to find. But you can water bath can in anything. You need a big pot. You can water bath can in that. You can make jellies. You could make things like that ahead of time if you could find the canning jars now. But anything that you could think of, think ahead. Use your brain. You know, what might I need? Are you on oxygen? Do you take medication? Maybe you ought to start looking into medicinal medications like plants and trees and mushrooms and things like that. Maybe you ought to start learning about that now or buy a book on that now so you'll have it later on so you could look into it. But just different things. It's always smart to plan ahead. Dana Coverstone and his dreams could be reality. They could be. They really could be. Something else you need is a Bible. Get yourself a Bible and find God. Do that. You need that in your life because the only way you're going to get through all of this is with God in your life. You need God. Nothing ever is easy in life. Just because you have God in your life doesn't mean it's going to get any easier. But be prepared. Plan ahead. Have a Bible and have God in your life. Just because you have God in your life too doesn't mean that He's just going to provide. You can't expect God just to, oh, boom, there it is. Sometimes He might do that. But you have to plan ahead. You have to work. You have to work also. With you working and God alongside of you, He'll help you. He'll help you. There's my video on planning ahead. If you want to subscribe for more, because I'm going to be showing more things that I can think of or that I'm going to do, I can show you how to do. Subscribe. All right. I'll see you next time. Bye.